Be sober and rest your hope fully upon the grace of Christ. Be sober and rest your hope fully upon the grace that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. 1 Peter 1:13. So, this is a continuation of the last video, but on the same verse, the second part of it, and that is to be sober and rest our hope fully upon the grace of Christ. So, again, we are to be clear-minded. If there's anything distracting you today, that's pushing down on you, that's pulling you away, beware. And also take an inventory. Take an inventory of your focus. Take an inventory of submitting yourself to God. Are you submitted? Are you yielded? Are you allowing anything to interfere with your worship, with your quiet time, with those things you do, you know, that bring you close to God? Okay? And worship does. Yes, worship. And reading the Word does. And prayer absolutely does. And these things will build you into the Lord, will grow you into the Lord. And also, as you live this life, because again, Peter is writing this, what, in 62, 64 AD, lots of persecution. All of the Jewish Christians have been scattered here, and he is encouraging them and encouraging us right now, right? Because there is an attempt to scatter us too, to weaken us and to just dismiss us, and worse. So, clear-minded, looking straight to God. That's what this is. It means being focused straight on God. Are you focused straight on God today? Is he your hope? Are you staying in that today? Let nothing else, no one, no teacher, no guide, no prophet, nothing other than the living Jesus Christ be the one that you set your hope on, okay? There are so many false prophets out there today, so many false teachers. And what happens is well-meaning Christians will be worshiping the Lord, reading the Bible, wondering, is there more? Is there more? Yes, there's a whole lot more. We can have a lot more of God in our worship. We can have a lot more of allowing the Spirit of Jesus Christ, okay, invade and transform and move us to have a vibrant life. We don't need a teacher and a prophet to bring that to us. We don't need that. As a matter of fact, beware if someone says, I have it. Just let me tell you what God told me. And you know, test the spirits. There are so many people out there that they start out well and they don't realize that they've gotten drunk on these prophets, okay? So be sober and rest your hope fully on the grace of Christ, not a teacher, a prophet, and a guide, okay? Jesus Christ, okay? Nothing else. And this whole thing about grace, the way I've heard it before is the Lord has mercy on us. He saved us, okay? We were destined for hell. We would have had no place with God, except he came and was the blood atonement. That is mercy when we didn't deserve it, right? And grace, imagine that. Imagine going before a judge, and not only does he say, forgiven, free, this is not going to be held against you. Here's $1 million. I'm going to give you more. Well, that's amazing, isn't it? The grace of God is overflowing and giving us more than we deserved. We have heaven, my friend. We're talking about this right now in this word, right? So be clear-minded, be sober, be vigilant, and let no one or nothing interfere with your focus on God today. And let the fruit of that, your focus on the fruit of that, just draw people to him. God bless you.